Truth Report presented by your local Kia dealers.
Well, thanks a lot, Bob. The Yankees win this one 5-4. And, you know, even though it wasn't the sharp, dominant Jay Happ that we saw for much of last season, David, are there some positives that he can take from what he did after that tough second inning, still delivering what ended up being his 11th win of the year?
Yeah, you could see kind of maybe a little bit of anger come out with Jay Happ. His fastball started jumping after that three-run home run. He did end up with seven strikeouts on the night, and even though he never really got his secondary pitches worked in very well, he got a little extra mustard on that fastball. He started jumping at 93, 94 miles an hour. He went back to his old style and said, the heck with it, I'm going to do what I know I can do. And he did, and he got through five innings. And even though his pitch count was a little elevated at that point, approaching 100 pitches, he did finish up with the Yankees with the lead, and the bullpen from that point on really took it from there. Four innings of one-run ball.
And offensively, Mike Ford, we see him really locked in. Two more home runs tonight, David. What has stood out to you about Ford, not just tonight, but in this recent stretch?
Well, he's a guy that you kind of want to see more of, right? I mean, he's such a great story. All those years in the minor leagues, kind of looked over and passed over constantly, finally gets his chance. And his profile is so interesting. His minor league numbers are terrific. The under the hood look, as they say, his exit velocity and all the metrics really line up well. He's got well above average numbers in regards to that. And then it's just kind of getting reps, getting more at-bats, getting a chance, and he's finally getting it. He still doesn't have 100 plate appearances in the big leagues this year, but he has 8 home runs. And think about that as you go out to 500 at-bats. You're talking about a 35 or 40 home run pace. This guy's for real. He's legit. It's nice to see him get a chance.
For Gleyber Torres, now 33 home runs on the season. David, he could say, hey, I'm just a contact hitter, but it's incredible the consistent power we are seeing from him. And he's 22 years old. What a star the Yankees have.
Well, he is. I mean, you talk about all the great young superstars in this game, and it seems like another one comes up every other week in today's game. This guy's right on the front page. You talk about the top five best players, young players in the game. You're talking about a young superstar without a doubt. And 22 years old. I mean, the future's so bright for the Yankees, and this kid, he just keeps getting better and better, and his confidence grows and grows. And you just wonder, you know, how good is he really going to be when he gets to the point of peaking? And I don't think he's there yet.
Quite a few good stories tonight in a 5-4 win, Bob, as we send it back to you in the studio.